Hello there. Former UKIP leader and current Brexit Party leader, Nigel Farage, has decided to rebrand his Brexit Party into Reform UK, following the promises he made before the 2019 general election. Firstly, please subscribe and like this video to give my channel a boost. And I'm always uploading new content, so please do check back daily. And a big thanks to my Patreon and PayPal supporters. Nigel Farage has applied to the Electoral Commission to change the name of the Brexit Party to Reform UK, all part of his promised plan to change UK politics for good. Although seen primarily as a single issue, get the UK out of the EU party, after the EU MEP elections, the Brexit Party did stand on a broader platform in the general election of reforming UK politics in such areas as the House of Lords. Although I don't remember any detailed manifesto being produced. And on the party's website it does say, "We stand for a clean break Brexit that will enable us to take control of our laws, borders and money. That is not only about the EU. It is about what sort of democratic country we live in. We're out to challenge the self-serving two-party system, make the people sovereign and restore trust in our democracy." With Nigel Farage himself saying yesterday that, "As promised, we continue to keep a very close eye on the government's trade negotiations with the EU to ensure a proper Brexit. Further reform in many other areas is also vital for our nation's future." Now, as I understand it, Reform UK will be standing candidates in the local elections in May 2021. And this will cover mayoral, devolved assembly, police and crime commissioner and council elections, including those carried over from those elections postponed earlier this year due to the pandemic. This, of course, assumes that there will be local elections next year. Given how this government is performing at present, the last thing they might want is a test at the ballot box. And with an imminent lockdown that was initially due to last until December the 2nd, now being touted as possibly months long, who knows if it will be used as an excuse to delay once more. Now, I'm no fan of postal voting, but this may be the time for people to start thinking about applying. The more postal voters there are, the greater the argument to hold those elections. Now, there are a couple of other interesting angles to this move by Farage, with the central point being that the main driver for going for it now appears to be his deep criticism of the way the UK government has handled the pandemic. Having watched one of Farage's videos, I do get the impression that he has a relatively low opinion of the Health Secretary Matt Hancock. Now, with the government looking to have successfully bounced itself into the lockdown starting on Thursday, many Tory MPs are getting a bit twitched. Many aspects of a new lockdown are playing on their minds, not least the state of the UK economy. There are therefore declarations by some Tories that they will be voting against their own government, and signs that others might follow suit. And even at this late stage, if Farage can be seen to start applying pressure, then maybe others might follow suit. But, and here's the big but, that leads me into the second angle on this. Both the mainstream press and the social media bosses seem to be firmly wedded to the government's approach, to the effect that most TV, radio and print commentators and journalists talk rather warmly of locking down to save the NHS. Remember that the press generally thrives on death, destruction and destitution. And to say that social media seems, configured to support the current official pandemic position could be seen by many as an understatement. That puts Farage firmly on the publicity back foot. Now, in the past, Farage has been able to get in front of the press and cameras and successfully make his case, despite many of the outlets disliking his politics. but social media had seemed much more equitable, and he and his supporters were able to use it to great effect to both garner support and to direct its efforts. But with the way that social media appears to be blocking anything other than the single lockdown approach, you have to wonder how much leeway he would get. Also, Nigel Farage is currently denied his favourite political medium of mass gatherings. That is where he shines, performing to a crowd. Mobilising door-to-door canvassing or leafleting will also prove problematic over the next few months. All this favours those already entrenched in their political seats. But timing here is critical. Because should the US elections result in a status quo result, or even a more than status quo result from what I'm picking up, then the social media issue could be turned on its head. We could see the social media giants come under intense pressure quite quickly to allow a broader and deeper debate. And this would have a spillover effect onto mainstream media. And a proper, unstifled public debate would inevitably ensue, something that Farage could only benefit from, to the cost of the mainstream parties. Now, there is another huge factor that has exploded on the scene that will also bolster Reform UK, and that is the near civil war in the Labour Party. The Tories are probably expecting a battering in the elections next May, and so expected Labour to soak up the seats. But with the Labour Party in disarray over the anti-Semitism issue, with Corbyn supporters almost in party split mode, many voters on the left may well be looking for a new home for their ballot paper cross. And if you think the wishy-washy Lib Dems are going to successfully fill that slot, then good luck to you. It now comes down to how adventurous Farage is, as well as how well funded he is. Standing councillors isn't too much of a problem, except for finding people to actually stand in the first place. Recruiting would need to start now. And on the bigger ticket openings, such as Mayor and Police and Crime Commissioner, there will be more takers to stand, but their costs are far higher. It takes a £5,000 deposit to stand for PCC, and the signature requirements are far more onerous. But if Nigel Farage wants Reform UK to make a massive splash, then he needs to go at this one like he did the EU elections, especially with no general election in the offing. But that also goes for any other political party sitting in the wings waiting for their moment. Now, Nigel Farage has a well-proven political nous and a reputation for judging the mood of the people. So I'm sure that this initiative of his matches what an increasing number of ordinary people are thinking. Anyway, if you want to hear more from me, please don't forget to subscribe and also press that little bell, or you won't get any notifications. And if you want to see more of me, buy a mug with my mug on it by following the link in the descriptions box below and support me on Patreon or PayPal. So what do you think of Nigel Farage and Reform UK? Please share and comment, and thank you for watching.